If you want to live, get out of my way.
Oh no, a dead end! And so the adventure came to a close in a most sudden and unsatisfying manner!
Look, that wall is cracked. That means...
You better be ready.
So it's real, but you won't get us away.
So exorcists are actually the vessels for their malakim. You can do that too, can't you, Mogulu?
Of course! This fair maiden has won the Malakim's Choice Award, Most Desirable Vessel, 3 years running!
Oh? Then you wouldn't mind replacing Eleanor as Lafayette's vessel, I hope.
Thanks, but no thanks. I have my hands full dealing with Bienfu as it is.
If I ate Bienfu, you'd have room.
Still wouldn't work, kiddo. You saw it with your own eyes. Even if only for an instant, that kid actually held his own against the power of Enominat. Not even the resplendent Mogulu can handle something of that power.
Indeed. After everything we've seen, it's obvious there's more to Lafayette than meets the eye.
Yeah, but that Eleanor woman was still able to become his vessel.
That's because, unlike Miss Mogulu, Madame Eleanor actually tries!
Anyway, we need to find her and beat her. She'll just bring us more trouble the longer she's out there.
Oh, we'll find her. No doubt about it.
This looks like some kind of ruin. Where are we?
Judging from the style of the walls and columns, I'd say this place is an ancient underground temple of Eumacia.
Eumacia, the Empyrean of Earth.
So it was by no coincidence that the Earth Pulse led us here.
How did the temple builders know where to dig to connect to an Earth Pulse? Did they just get lucky? Just wham, there it is?
An Earth Pulse doesn't work that way. It's a flow of natural force ordinary humans can't sense. But in those days, there were more humans capable of sensing that which others couldn't. It was people like that who guided the rest to build their temples closer to the Earth Pulses, closer to their gods.
Uh-huh.
So, since Empyreans control the forces of nature, people viewed the Earth Pulses as embodiments of the gods themselves. Is that it?
Right. In the time when Empyrean worship was at its peak, temples like this were built all over.
And I'm guessing they all looked pretty similar, so until we go outside, we're no closer to knowing where we are.
That sums it up.
I wonder if they found any high-quality ore when they dug this hole. You know, for making swords.
I don't know why I bother explaining anything to you.
You know, I'm starting to think you just enjoy it.
You guys again?
Well, look who set up shop here.
You couldn't have shown up at a better time. We need more supplies.
I'm happy to help you all, but this time I really, really needs to charge a little extra.
How much extra are we talking here?
Ooh, you haven't heard the stories, little turtles. Word has it, there's a spooky monster that's been eating traveling merchants around these parts.
Eating merchants?
She takes the shape of a black-haired girl, and when she finds greedy merchants, she gobbles them up head first. Although, if the greedy merchant was a turtle's, I bet she'd start with the crunchy shell.
Ah! I'm not greedy, I swears it. Look, I had special sales going on. Everything's marked down to normal prices.
How generous of you. Mogulu, give the nice turtles the smile he lives for.
Always a pleasure.
Much obliged.
Scout.
Finish this quick! Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try! Perfect mayhem! Hold up! Too slow!
but I'm this close. I won't miss! Form Zero!
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
I thought you'd be long gone.
I apologize for disappearing on you. I was there, and then in the next moment, I was gone.
And Lafayette?
He's resting inside me. As far as I can tell, he seems healthy again.
Your name's Eleanor, right? If I defeat you, you'll be his vessel and follow my orders until the day you die.
I accept. But conversely, should you lose, I will take your life.
Do you plan on fighting alone?
I can handle myself.
Versus you.
I'd better not hear any excuses after your defeat, then. We're done here.
Never let your guard down, even when victorious!
Why did you stop?
I know you can't kill me as long as I'm his vessel. I'm just abiding by the same terms.
Had you won, you'd have killed me.
True, but a duel is a duel.
The Abbey shaped you well. However! Once your sword is drawn, never waver. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle, right?
Lord Artorias' teachings? What a failure I have been. I'll keep my word. I will follow your orders. To the day I die!
Don't!
My body... I can't move! How? Since when can a Moloch overpower his own vessel?
Lafayette, are you feeling better now?
Yeah.
Looks like her body is reacting to the bond.
Yeah, I know the drill. She'll get a high fever and stay zonked out for a bit. No biggie.
Carrying her will slow us down. We can't afford that risk when we're venturing into parts unknown.
Let's rest here until she's recovered, then. She's one of us now, isn't she? As long as she's Lafayette's vessel.
That's true.
Man, Artorias and Innominaut. Either one of them's a force to be reckoned with.
Then why do you look so happy?
Because I'm still alive. And if I'm alive, I can fight.
You're certainly optimistic.
That's just the sort of demon I am. What about you, though? You gonna call that whole revenge thing off?
If only. That's just the sort of demon I'm not.
Then we need to find a way to beat them. You can mope after you're dead.
We? You're still going to help?
Yeah. After all, I wouldn't be here if Lafayette hadn't saved my life. Surely you know me by now. I might not look it, but duty and honor flow through my veins.
A demon, a Moloch, a witch, and now an exorcist. We've turned into a real band of misfits.
I didn't have any other choice. We're stuck with her.
Yeah, I know. We can't afford to lose Lafayette, now that we know the full extent of Innominaut's strength. We need that boy more than ever.
Do you think Innominaut really is an Empyrean?
You got me, but I do know this. Whatever he is, he's no ordinary Moloch, and the Abbey intends on using that power. To what end, I couldn't say.
If we're going to win this, we need to uncover Innominaut's true nature and the Abbey's secret goals.
Indeed. At the very least, I think we can safely assume that Eifried's disappearance is part of their schemes. We might be able to extract some information out of that Eleanor woman as well.
Agreed. But no torture. I'm not shattering our only vessel.
Yeah, I get that. Given the pact they share, if Eleanor goes down, Lafayette becomes a demon, right?
What? No one told me that!
That's just how it is between Moloch and Vessel. I know she's a threat, but we need to keep her close for the time being.
Well, we sure are in it deep now.
I'll look after Madame Eleanor. You know, I just remembered. After Miss Mogilu and I made our pact, she couldn't stop sneezing and sniffling for months! That happened right when spring was starting.
Hey, don't overwork yourself.
I'm sorry.
Why are you apologizing?
Isn't it obvious? I disobeyed you, Velvet.
Don't sweat it. I'm still alive, thanks to you.
I didn't want to see you die. That's why I did that. To save you.
I'm sorry, too. Acting the way I did. Treating you like an object.
When I came with you, that was my own choice. You gave me the freedom to choose.
And what would you choose now? We only have more troubles ahead.
You're still going to fight, aren't you?
Yeah, I can't stop now.
Even so, I've made my choice. I'm coming with you.
I see.
Anyway, it's not like I have any idea where we are now.
That's a good point.
But an object misused is one thing. A person misused is quite another.
What's your point?
What's your point, is what I want to know. Not only did you blow the whole revenge thing, you didn't even leave a scratch. Do you have any plan on where to go from here?
I'll admit it. The Nominot's power is far beyond what I could ever have imagined. But I'll never give up. No matter how many times I have to try, I'll devour them all.
Bet you 100 gold you break first.
Huh?
You heard me. 100 gold says that you give up. I lost a bet with Rokuro when you had to go and survive. Cost me 10 gold! I'm just looking to come out on top.
Whatever, fine.
Oh, then it looks like we have a bet. There might be some fun in me sticking around after all. Not that I much care how it all turns out. I'm just looking to kill time.
Hey, Velvet. I've got something that might help with Nominot.
Oh. Is this that book you took from the villa?
It is. Look closely at the crest on the cover.
It's the same one from the temple. Does that book say anything about Nominot?
Yes. But I can't read it. It's written in the ancient tongue.
Oh, don't cry, baby boy. My friend Grimoire might be able to decipher that for you.
Really?
Well, maybe, maybe not. She'd have to take a look first.
Well, where is she? Your friend, I mean.
No idea. The last letter I got from her was sent from Isolt down in Southgand.
Not much to work with here.
True, but I'll have fun watching you try.
Oh, I'll find her. Don't you worry about that.
That's the spirit. Don't give up just yet.
We'll rest inside these ruins. You're still weak.